to the chairs and the audience. We work at University of Hyderabad on different aspects of related to the dengue virus infections. One of them is the how the different strains of this virus is affecting the its disease potentiality in the country and outside also. This recently, this virus is infections are not necessary to introduce much. Causing diseases more than 100 countries. 500 to 50 to 100 million people are being infected every year. Number recently rise to the 390 million. Just this one, this slide shows the upper panel. What is the spread of this virus during 1970s and what is the spread it expands to the year 2004. In 1970, only few countries and also very less endemic, that means all four strains infected. But in 2004, it entire world infected. The right side table indicates the scenario of the India in starting in 1964 and 2012. Just to have the idea of symptoms, it ranges from just simple illness to the severe complications. Severe complications means it goes to the hemorrhagic fever or the shock syndrome, finally which leads for the death. This different, as per the World Health Organization, different signs and symptoms are marked where we can consider as the DHF or DHS, DSS, and it ranges the eye infections, skin rashes, lung enlargement in the severe cases. See, the virus, how it behaves in the infection, based on that some of the diagnostic tests were standardized and being used. The virus incubation is up to 10 days, during which the viral is very high during the first few days and then comes down. During that stage, the platelets test will come down, which is the hallmark of the dengue virus infections. If you see, based on that variant, NS1 test, which is most what is commonly being used in first few days, that is up to 5 days. After that, it can also be checked. But IgG, IgM also there, which is also have some limitations, what I mean to say. So this just few things about this virus. This virus belongs to the family of flaviviruses, of which the hepatitis C virus, Japanese encephalitis virus, recent Zika virus also belongs. And these viruses are the enveloped virus particles of nearly 30 to 40 nanometers in size and its RNA genome. This genome is size is 11 kb and encodes 10 different proteins with untranslated regions on both sides. So this is the Indian scenario. Number of cases being increased recently and the severity of also increased. As I told, this virus contains four different serotypes. Again, each serotype is subdivided into the genotypes. The red one in each serotype indicates the genotypes which are reported from India. So this, for the severity, there are many accounts, like from the host side, from the individual side, both side, environmental side, all together. So considering these points, our lab involved in the identification of the strains, genome characterizations, host variants, some of the main areas to understand the reason behind the severity of the virus. As in this direction, we have collected the few clinical samples from different areas of the two states, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, and then listed the clinical characteristics. Most of them are severe complicated samples, and the interesting thing is all of them are primary infections. There is meaning in primary and secondary infections, Until now, dengue infections are known to be very severe in secondary infections, but all these cases are severe in during the first for primary infections itself. So, in this attempt as the first step, we have tried to identify the serotype. This is a simple test where we isolated the RNA, then compounded the PCR, and then analyzed on the average gel electrophoresis. Based on the size of the product, end product, we can say the which serotype it belongs. So, in that way, in from this region, then 1, 2, 3 and 4 altogether identified. This is the first thing when in any given geographical area at a given point of time, all 4 serotypes being identified. Another thing is, it's okay in one patient if one serotype is there. We have identified multiple serotypes in a given single patient, that's co-infections. That accounts for the increased severity of the disease because number of serotypes increases the viral load, which accounts for the severity. And one interesting point is there in this viral infections, each serotype antibodies never protects the other serotype, rather than it enhances their multiplication and means severity it goes up. And one patient, we have identified all 4 serotypes in a single patient. So then we have looked carefully the data, which serotype is causing more DHF, DSS. Then one night showed the severe form. Two also like that, only. All those things showed very severe disease. And this severe disease, if it is co-infections, you can see the last one, which is more mixed infections, more co-infections, and they showed the nearly 80% of the DHF. So this is the table, 80% of the patient with co-infection showed the severe thing. And next we have further gone down, what is the genotype of that each serotype. Then in one case, it was genotype 3, and in serotype 2, it was genotype 4, and 3, it was genotype 3, and 4, it was genotype 1. So, that was the identified up to the genotype levels. Then, what was the further details in these genotypes? In that direction, we have carried the complete genome sequencing of all 3 serotypes among the 4. We could not do the 3, but 1, 2 and 4 completely characterized using the different sets of primers for each serotype. These are the gel. After amplification, we have unlocked on the gel and cloned them and sent for the sequencing. One thing is what we have noticed in case of serotype 1. Until now, there are many such studies are going on in India. They have reported, published, sequenced and all. These strains occurring in this area did not match anyone. It's matched to the strains which are characterized during 1980 in India and during that time which are circulated in the Thailand. With them only it's going. That orange is indicated. Interestingly, those strains reported that time, they are also associated with DHF and DSS. And then throughout the segments, we have seen many mutations. And what is the meaning of that mutation, what are the contributions, we are still like progressing. Another important thing is, this virus contains the untranslated region on both sides. What is happening in serotype 1, if you see the top, these two, this area, so that is the continuous stretch of this thing, and then gap occurs. In our things, again continuous stretch occurs. This continuous stretch meaning is, this virus multiplication, it requires lot of host factors to bind. That host factors binds to this region only. Since that region is lacking that continuous stretch, some of the strains become kind of handicapped. And then now, because they are severe, we are expecting this because of the reappearance of this missed part of the genome, please. Similarly, we sequenced the DEN2, please. And here also we found the continuous stretch which is missing all the characteristics from the Indian side, please. Four also we continued, which is the second from our side, and in India only two complete sequences are there. Ours is the second one, and we have published some of the data and looking for.